Hi guys, so today I just want to do a quick tutorial on how to upload images from your photos library into Design Space, and also how to get images from your phone to your computer so that you can work on Design Space on your PC. So first, if your image already exists on your phone, let's just find any image on the phone. Let's just do these flowers. And I want to send it to my PC, I would just, to the bottom left, I would just hit the little icon there and I just email it to myself. It's the simplest way to do that. Just email it to yourself and then you can go onto your computer and download it from there. The other thing that we can do is if your image does not exist on your PC, let's say I'm working on a project that's my avatars, so I don't have that already saved, I just go into a text message and I send the emoji. So I just pick any of the emojis and send it to myself. So once I get it, I could just make the image larger and then do a photo screenshot of it. So just hold, I'm on the iPhone X, so just hold the two side keys and squeeze together, and then you'll do a photo snapshot of your image, and then you go back to your photo library. And there it is. And then again, you would just email it to yourself. Perfect. So those are gone to my email. So now if we want to import those into Design Space, what we would have to do is hit upload. Hit upload at the bottom, select from photo library. You want to find the images, just do all photos, bring in my emoji. There it is. But as you can see, the emoji, when we did a snapshot of it, it has all of this unusable space that we on the top and the bottom. So you go to the bottom and you see the little crop and you click on that and you drag the little side arrows close enough that you crop out most of the white space. Make sure you don't crop the hair or anything like that. And then when you're done, you hit done, and on the bottom left you'll see where it says remove. You click on that and you tap on anywhere in the white corners, and what that does is it now takes away the background and creates your little avatar as a transparent image, so that it will do a die cut for labels, which is what I'm working on in my next project. So you want to save this as a print and cut. If you just want your silhouette and you just want to do that at a vinyl, then you just keep the cut image. But as I'm doing labels, I tap on the print and cut and make sure that the one with the little check mark on the top right is the one that you want selected. And then I just do me hearts. You want to name it so that later on you can find it. You just hit done. It'll save the image into the library where you have all of your other images already stored. And then you would just select it and insert it into your Design Space. Once you have it in there, all you need to do is resize it to whatever shape, to whatever size you want, and then create your project. So that's it from the phone. Let's go to the computer now and see how you can upload from there to your PC. Okay, so now we're on our Gmail, because we emailed those two images to us. So the first email that I did was the bouquet, and all I do is just hit download and it'll download onto my computer, and then go back to the other email and download my emoji. So both of those are scanning, and then you know it's working and it's downloading. So then I go into Design Space, into a new canvas, and I want to bring them up. So to do that, we have to hit upload image. And let's find it. So browse. So when you download something onto your computer from like your email or from somewhere, there's a downloads folder, which is sort of like a temporary hold. And there are the two latest images that we did. So let's bring in the bouquet. And then I just want to keep it just as is. So you just hit continue. It's obviously, this will be a print and cut because of all the colors. And then just hit save, and it'll go with the rest of the images that I have, which is right here. And then just do the same thing to get your little avatar. Go back into downloads. There's the little avatar. So remember, we cleaned it up on the iPhone when we brought it into Design Space, but now we emailed it to ourselves the same way we took a snapshot of it from our phone. So I'll select complex because there's different colors and there's cropping and things involved. So I always like to select complex on the images. So once we get to this step, this is where you do the cleanup for your images. So this is where you crop it and you just keep the part that you want. And if you want to make it transparent, you go up here to select and erase and click on anywhere in the white space. And then your image is now transparent in the back. You keep it as a print and cut. If you just wanted a silhouette of your image, then you would just do it as a cut and do it in vinyl. But for the purposes of what I'm doing, I want to keep the full image. And then you hit save and it brings it into your Design Space. And then all you have to do is select the images you want to bring into your canvas. And it should bring the two images that we uploaded onto our computer. And there they are. All you need to do is resize and just create your project. So hopefully that was helpful. Make sure to hit subscribe so that you don't miss any future videos. And hit like if you found value in this video. It's Arlene from A Crafty Latina, and I will talk to you soon.